Hey everybody, welcome back to Stamping School. So starting next month in February 2021, you're going to be seeing a lot of chickens. There's chickens everywhere. You're going to be seeing chicken cards more than you can handle because this is coming back, which is a stamp set that we had back in 2016. It was a celebration stamp set. So if you've been around with Stampin' Up! For a while, you probably earned this cutie free. But they're going to bring back the stamp set, plus they're making some dies for it, which is really fun. So even if you already have this one, you'll be able to get the dies separately. Or if you're new to Stampin' Up!, you can get both of them as a bundle. So this one, Hey Birthday Chick, is in the January through June catalog, mini catalog right now. And starting February 2nd, you can get the dies for it. So let me show you what they look like. So first, I'm going to show you the older set. This is the one from 2016 that they're bringing back. Now, when you buy it new today, it's got the really good labels on it. But back then, our labels didn't stick so great. They were that really glossy, shiny. We had a hard time getting them to stick. So if you have one of the old sets, remember we carry this cling adhesive. And I did a video on it. I'll link to it below just so that you guys have it. But how to make these stick better. And if I tilt it to the light, you can see I put a little strip on there. There it is right there. See that strip? So that makes it nice and tacky so it sticks to your blocks better. But I realized that when I took out this old set and was like, oh my gosh, this is the old stickers. We've come a long way just in 5 years. So let me show you what they did with the dies. So of course it cuts out the three chickens right here, but there's also this little chicken wire, little die right here. There is a little sign, the three greetings that came in that stamp set, a couple of eggs, and there's a little texture on that. Can you see it? Yeah, some texture. And a corn stalk. So you get like four little corn cobs and the little, I don't know what those are. I don't know my corn terminology, but corn stalk with corn. And then there's a little wooden stump. See the texture on it? And a chicken coop that has texture. There you go. You can see it better that way. And then this one, which will just cut out wherever you put it, which I assume is like little feed or something. Isn't that cute? So that's the one. And I'll just say a little tip. If you're getting both of them, I make a copy of the dies right away before I take them off the sheet. And I put the copy back here because these, I'm going to get them confused. I just know it. So I made copies of the dies first and put them in the correct packages because I can just see myself getting everything mixed up. So here is the second one. This is the one that's in the mini catalog right now. The companion set. So look at this little guy. So cute. So all about birthday with the balloon and the hat and the cupcake. This one's just all out happy. You get a happy birthday die. There's a little streamer, a little bow tie. If you want your chicken to have a bow tie, go for it. A little baby chick, a little feed bag, a little fence, and then this little scritchy scratchy guy, which we're gonna use today. And then a confetti, let's celebrate you. You're still a spring chicken. Happy birthday, best of cluck. So look at this. It's a lot of fun. And it's a lot of chicken. Now that introductions are out of the way, I'm gonna show you the card we're gonna make today. Isn't that cute? This is a little peek through window card. It's been called a lot of different things. We used to call them bridge cards, window bridge cards, so I'll just go with that. The peekaboo cards. Basically, the middle's missing and we've got a window here. And if this was sturdy enough, you don't have to put the window sheet behind it, but this was a little delicate because it's just that holding it together, so I did a little window. But I like the little peek through quality. A little cupcake. Oh. And the spring chickens up there. All right, well let's make the base of the card first. I'm doing Knight of Navy. And I'm starting with Knight of Navy, 4 1/4 by 11, score and landscape position at 5 1/2. So fold it in half to make just your regular A2 card. But we need to cut this little section out right here. So I just wanna leave this 2-inch piece right here. So we're gonna just cut off 3 1/4 from the front panel. Here, cut that piece off, and then out of this we also need a few more pieces. We need this little bottom panel right down here, And that's 1.5 inches. So we're going to cut that off at 1.5. So we need this little 1.5 panel right here. And then we also need 2 little 1/2 inch strips back here because we're going to cover our adhesive. So I'm just going to come in here and we're going to cut 2 1/2 inch pieces. So we're not wasting too much from the card. Right. Now this flower paper is so cute. It's one of the celebration freebies. And right now, when you spend $50, you get to choose packs of paper. There's a stamp set. There's that cute donkey. There's some greeting sets. I just love the colors with the white and the seaside spray and the navy. So I'm going to use that seaside spray on the inside right here because I want a little bit of that sky poking through. This is a little panel cut down, 4 by 5 1/4. You know you can print the measurements, so I'll put those in the comments in the description there. Here's the paper, by the way, the paper blooms that's free. It's 12 by 12. I just have these 6 by 6 samples, but you can see how pretty this paper is. And I thought about, on the bottom, using this one instead of the crumb cake. But it just seemed very busy. I thought it could kind of be grassy, but we're just going to go crumb cake, so there's kind of a neutral there. Now, here's that bottom piece. And I've got a piece of crumb cake, and I did some of those little scritchy scratches. That's that little die. You can just move it anywhere, and it gives you those little scritchy scratches. That's going to go right here, just like a little layer. And then we can put together this window. So this is what I do. I turn it inside out like this and put this upside down here, and we're going to line these pieces together. Now I know it's hard to see because it's all navy on navy. Here, I'll put this piece of white in here just so you can kind of see what I'm doing. All right, so line these up. Now I just like to make sure that it's not going anywhere, so I just kind of tack it down with a little washi tape. Take some of the stick off the washi tape so when you tear it back off, it doesn't tear your paper though. You just need enough just to hold it down for you, just like that. All right, enter the piece of window sheet, acetate, report covers. People use all kinds of things. This is cut at 2.5 inches. And there's a little border on each side. So that gives us about 1/2 inch. And normally what people would do is do, and I've done this before, is you do the adhesive right here and then cover it. And you can do that, but we can kill 2 birds with 1 stone. We're gonna glue on top of the window sheet along the seam. So this little tear and tape is perfect for that, or if you have a really strong adhesive. You're gonna go right across, and that's gonna hold it down. So I'm going half on the cardstock, half on the window sheet, okay? And then when I take this paper tape off like that, get my washi tape out of the way, then I can just add, this is sticky, I can just add my strip to cover that up. And put that there. I'm just doing navy on navy just so it's not as noticeable. Here we go. So see that the window sheet is staying put because it's half on and half off. So I don't have to glue and then put the window sheet down and glue again. This is just a one and done right here. And then we can flip it back. And there it is. So the most important thing is just that this all lines up, you know, that it just looks nice and even and looks great. I think the first time I remember doing this card, my friend Emily and I did a Christmas stamp stack years ago, and it was horizontal, and we had the Santa and the acetate window and the sentiment. It was such a great card. It was many, many years ago. Same exact size piece is going to go down here. Crumb cake, just so the chickens have something to stand on. All right, let's do the fence. I've got 2 fences that I die cut. One is going to go on this side and one's going to go on the other side. And I just want just a teeny little drop at the very bottom, just right there. I'm going to line these up right here. So that bottom of the fence goes right where the seam of the crumb cake is. And that's because when I go to the inside, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to line this up, but I'm going to move it way over here on this side to here. So when I close the card, they kind of look like they meet a little bit. That one even can come up just a wee bit. So it kind of looks like they're continuing across. You're not going to see it that much. It's not that big of a deal, but it does look nice. All right, let's bring in these chickens. Here they are. So I have stamped them in basic gray, which is a dark, dark gray. It is not waterproof so that I can bring in my blends and I can color with those. I wanted the chickens to be white because, well, at least this one and this one, because it's going on that color background. So there's very little coloring to do with it, which is great. I think I'm going to change the feet to orange instead of yellow because blue and orange look so great together. And we're just going to color in the little feet and the little beaks right here. So cute. Oops. And no fussy cutting because the dyes were right there. I wanted the red to repeat three times, so we're going to do the hat, his little crown, what is that called, and the balloon. What is that little thing called at the top of the rooster's head? Is it a crown? I don't know. I love white chickens that have a little bit of red popping on them, so he's really cute. And I'm doing a light soft suede for this little guy because he's got a white egg. And then I'll show you how to add a little bit of shading on the white chicken, just to see a little bit of definition. When you color in the balloon, try to leave just a little bit of it white for the little glimmer. The other reason I didn't want to color the chicken in completely is because when you open this up, you might be able to see the coloring behind it because the alcohol markers, you know, they always show the color on the back side. They kind of go through. So I wanted as little coloring as possible. So we're going to take the light smoky slate and just a wee bit here and there, and literally just little spots. I'm just kind of dabbing the color in, and it always lightens as it dries, just like with paint, and not much at all. I just want a little bit of definition. And a little bit around his head, just like that. And then we're gonna soften it. Same thing with this little guy right here. Just a wee bit around here and there. Then we use the color lifter, which it sounds like an eraser, but it's really not. Basically, it's just clear. And if you just kind of use the fine tip, which is, I call it the scrubber, you can kind of scrub it and soften it, and it just sort of blends everything in. You don't want to overdo it because it's going to soak through the paper. You want to just, and you know you're doing it right when you hear that. And that's it. If your balloon is too dark, you can kind of come in and you can take some of that away too. See how it just kind of lightens it up just a touch? And then we can put this little guy together. So I've got dimensionals here, put him right here. This guy is gonna go between the top and the bottom piece, and you only want the dimensionals kind of low, and this dimensional up here. So funny. Here, oops. Forgot this little part on my balloon. There we go. Super cute. I had this cloud die and I thought, oh, that'd be kind of fun to put some clouds up top. You might have a punch. Oh, I got a little bit too much glue there. That's why we have that silicone pad nearby. Take some of that off there. But you might have the cloud punch or something fun to put a little bit of something up here. I'm gonna use this glue right here for my happy birthday. Why not? There we go. A little happy birthday. I want that happy birthday to show through the window. Right about here would be good. Oop, too high. Move it down a little. Now you can do this chicken down here with a cupcake, but we also have the donkey right now, which should be really, really cute. kind of putting him down in here. The Darling Donkey is one of the Celebration freebies. Spend $50 and you get this cute little guy free. It's really cute. Let's see how he looks in the window. Yeah, he's kind of poking out there a little bit. That's kind of cute. I see lots of fun projects coming out with these chickens. I can't wait to see what everybody does with them. So thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.